Hello, it's Daizan here. I'm at Sarnath, the place where the Buddha gave his first teaching. Behind me is the Dhamek Stupa. It's believed that Dhamek, the modern name, is a contraction of Dharma Chakra, the Dharma wheel, the wheel of the teaching. This is the place where the Buddha set rolling the teaching, the wheel of the teaching of the Eightfold Path and so on. The stupa would originally have been an earth mound and has got various layers, apparently, been sort of built over the centuries. It's now largely built of brick and about 40 meters tall and in surprisingly good shape considering its age. It's surrounded by the foundations of what would have been brick-built monastery buildings in a kind of a parkland setting, which is very appropriate as the first teaching of the Buddha was said to have been in a deer park. So the Buddha realized enlightenment in Bodh Gaya and then traveled here in search of his five former students. Now, it's about my train journey yesterday to get here was about 5.5 hours or so. So walking, at a guess, we're talking a number of weeks, if not a month or two, to get here. So it's not exactly close. So he traveled quite a distance to meet these five former students. He came here, he sat down with them, and he began to speak. Initially, they didn't want to take him seriously. They'd already left him and sort of moved on, looking for further spiritual teachers or sustenance. But there was something about perhaps the authority with which he spoke that was remarkable to them. They listened, and he laid out the four noble truths, the truth that life contains suffering, contains less than satisfactory situations. What's the cause of this? Clinging or craving, tanha. The fact that there is an end to suffering. And then the fourth of the noble truths, the Eightfold Path, the way that suffering is dealt with. And as he was laying this out, as he was explaining this, Kondana, one of the students, actually got it. And the Buddha could recognize that. And we have this delighted explanation in the old texts. Kondana knows, Kondana knows. And so now there are two people in the world who understand this way and have achieved this liberation. And so the transmission from those who know to those who want to know was set in motion and has continued down through the centuries. And Zen Master Shinzan was very much one of those who gave his life to helping people who wanted to know, who wanted to find peace, who wanted to find liberation. He was somebody that they could come to. That's what his life was dedicated towards. He didn't make a lot of money. He wasn't well known. He just traveled to give his teaching or welcome people to Gyokuruji. That was his life. And so it feels very appropriate to have laid some of his relics in the earth here at Sarnath, the place where the teaching was set in motion.